Thank you. The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit, Father.
On this Palm Sunday, as we enter the week we call holy, we place ourselves in the Lord's presence, and as we prepare to celebrate the mystery of Christ's love in this Mass, let us pause to acknowledge our sins and failings and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Spogliadam się Bogu, wszelkiego serca,
i mam wiarę w Jezusa, że bardzo prosiłem, myślą o Bogu, dzięki Pisaniu Pana, Twoja wina, Twoja wina, Twoja praca i codziennie. Wszelko błagam Najświętszej Maryi, zawsze dziewicę, wszystkich narodów świętych, wybawam z praśni własnych, łagodnikiem zaraz do Pana Boga naszego.
Niech się miły nad nami Bóg Wszechmogący i odpuściwszy nam grzechy, doprowadzi nas do życia wiecznego. Panie, zmiłuj się nad nami.
Lord, have mercy.
Chryste, zmiłuj się nad nami.
Christ, have mercy.
Panie, zmiłuj się nad nami.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who, as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard, my face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Chrystus Jezus istnieją w postaci Bożej, jest korzystna w sposobności, aby darować nic Bogu, lecz odłączy samego siebie, przyjąwszy postać sługi, staje się podobnym do ludzi. A w serdecznej postaci, uznany za człowieka, uniżył samego siebie, staje się posłusznym aż do śmierci. I to śmierci krzyżowi. Dlatego też Bóg go na wszystko powyższył i darował imię ponad wszelkie imię, aby na imię Jezusa zdjęło się każde kolano, istot niebieskich i ziemskich i podziemnych. I aby wszelki język wyznał, że Jezus Chrystus jest Panem, ku chwale Boga Ojca. Oto słowo Boże.
Where may I eat the Passover with my
show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there.
The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they reclined at the table they were eating, Jesus said,
Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me.
They began to be distressed and said to him one by one,
Surely it is not I.
He said to them,
One of the 12, the one who dips with me into the ditch, for the Son of Man indeed goes as it is written of him. But woe to that man to whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that man if he had never been born.
While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it and gave it to them, and said,
Take it, this is my body.
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them,
This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen. I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God.
Then, after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
All of you will have your faith shaken, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be dispersed. But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you to Galilee.
Peter said to him,
Even though all shall have their faith shaken, mine will not be.
Then Jesus said to him,
Amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he vehemently replied,
Even though I should not die for you, I will not deny you.
And they all spoke similarly. Then they came to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
Sit here while I pray.
He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be troubled and distressed. Then he said to them,
My soul is sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and keep watch.
He advanced a little and fell to the ground, and prayed that if it were possible the hour might pass by him. He said,
Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Take this cup away from me, but not what I will, but what you will.
When he returned, he found them asleep. He said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
Withdrawing again, he prayed, saying the same thing. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open and did not know what to answer him. He returned a third time and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking no rest? It is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is to be handed over to sinners. Get up, let us go. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Then while he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal to him, saying,
The man I shall kiss is the one, arrest him, and lead him away as a prisoner.
He came and immediately went over to him and said,
Rabbi.
And he kissed him. At this time they laid hands on him and arrested him. One of the bystanders drew his sword, struck the high priest's servants, and cut off his ear. Jesus said to them in reply,
Have you come out as against the robber with swords and clubs to seize me? Day after day I was with you teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me, but that the scriptures may be fulfilled.
And they all left him and fled. Now a young man followed him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth upon his body. They seized him, but he felt the cloth behind and left naked. They led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and scribes came together. Peter followed him at a distance into the high priest's courtyard and was seated with the guards, warming himself of fire. The chief priests and the entire Sanhedrin kept saying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found him guilty. They gave false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and falsely accused him, alleging,
"We have destroyed this temple, and within 3 days I will build another, not made with hands."
Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest goes before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying,
"Have you no answer? What are these who have testified against you?"
But he was silenced and answered nothing. Again, the high priest asked him and said to him,
"Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Then Jesus answered,
"I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven."
At that, the high priest tore his garments and said,
"What further do you have of your witnesses? You have heard blasphemy. What do you think?"
They all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him and struck him and said to him,
"Prophesy."
And the guards greeted him with blows. While Peter was alone in the courtyard, one of the high priest's maids came along. Seeing Peter warming himself, she looked intently at him and said,
"You too were with the Nazarene of Jesus."
But he denied it, saying,
"I neither know nor understand what you are talking about."
So he went into the outer court, then the cock crowed. The maid saw him and began to say to bystanders,
"This man is one of them."
Once again he denied it. A little later, the bystanders said to Peter once more,
"Surely you are one of them.
He began to curse and to swear,
"I do not know this man about whom you are talking."
And immediately a cock crowed a second time. Then Peter remembered the word that Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times. He broke down and wept. As soon as the morning came, the chief priests with all the elders and the scribes, that is, the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him,
"Have you no answer? See how many things they accuse you of?"
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release them one prisoner whom they requested, a man called Barabbas. Was then in prison along with the rebels who had committed murder in the rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
"Do you want me to release you, the king of the Jews?"
For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas from him instead. Pilate again said to them in reply,
"Then what do you want me to do with the man called the king of the Jews?"
They shouted again,
"Crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
They only shouted louder,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them and said, after Jesus' words, handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is the Praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple, and weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him, and began to salute him with,
"Hail, King of the Jews!"
And kept striking his head with a reed and spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and when they mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify. They pressed into service a passerby, Simon, a Cyrenian who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine for the tumor, but he did not take it. They crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying, some of the bystanders who heard it said, one of them ran, soaked the sponge with wine, put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see Elijah God."
Jesus gave a loud cry of grief his next breath. The veil of the sanctuary was torn from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of the younger James, and Joseph and Salome. These men had followed him when he was in Galilee and ministered to him. Many other men came up with him to Jerusalem. When it was already evening, since it was the day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who was himself awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having brought a linen cloth, he took him down, wrapped him in the linen cloth, and laid him in a tomb, which had been hewn out of a rock. Then he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, watched where he was laid. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Then it's very easy for us, either call out and go.
inspiration or as human nature, who we blame God? It's his fault. I'm a good person. So why do I not feel good? I don't bother anybody. I don't cause any trouble. I go to church. I pray. How come this is happening to me? It's very easy for us to be in both problems. And that's exactly what all of Holy Week does for us. It allows us the opportunity to see Jesus in every single facet of our lives. Because we already saw two of them. Tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday. What happens to your morning? Not so much. They're what we would call regular, ordinary days. Notice they make up most of the week. Why? Because regular, ordinary days make up most of our life too. Check that box off. Jesus here with us. And then, on Holy Thursday, there is a celebratory meal around a holiday, gathering festively with family and friends. And who hasn't had the occasion to enjoy the company of those we love, those we share life with, for any occasion, holiday, birthday, celebration, wedding, baptism? Well, son of Jesus, check that box off too. But then by evening, he's agonizing in the dark. And which life hasn't had a shared agony at some time too. For whatever reason, for regardless of the source, Jesus was there as well. Then there's Good Friday. Jesus is falsely accused, falsely condemned, and suffers not because of something he did, but because of what other people did. And who hasn't been falsely condemned? Who hasn't suffered because of something that they didn't do? So Jesus. Then there's Holy Saturday, a deceptive day in a sense, because it seems tranquil and peaceful, and yet so much is going on behind the scenes. There's tension. And look at our lives, sure. We don't have any services except blessing the food during the day until the dish got out. But who isn't scurrying around to do all the 101 things necessary to make every holiday celebration what it should be? Who doesn't just turn up on the table? Eggs don't die themselves. Ask us to get prepared magically. There's a lot of work that goes into what seems to be typical. We share attention. So all week long, we have the opportunity to see how Jesus has experienced the parts of our life. But then comes Easter. And that's the one part that is yet to be experienced by us. Jesus' triumphal resurrection from the dead. That's something that we await. As we say in the Creed, I expect the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. And so, we must enter into this Holy Week, and of all the weeks in the year, this is one that should not be like every other week. There must be a way that we can do something, whether we can go to church or whether we stay at home, to make it come alive in our lives. We know the story. We know what happens out every day. Do we help to live it, to invite Jesus to be a part of our Holy Thursday, our Good Friday, our Holy Saturday? Because he invites us to be a part of his. And then if we do that, not just during one Holy Week, but if we keep the Lord present with us throughout our life, then something wonderful will happen. The day will come when it will be our turn to share in the glory of Easter and our own resurrection. Let us now stand to profess our faith. Today we will recite the Creed.
That the Holy Spirit may sanctify the church in her observances of this solemn week. Let us pray to the Lord. That Jesus may journey together with us through experiences of loss and sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that all who have died, remembering especially Conrad and Marina Kromit, may enter the heaven. Jerusalem, joining the angels and saints in giving glory to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
Orzech.
Thank you.
experienced it as a muscle for a good one. Have you sounded in the last hour? If you are, that's your companion, Jesus Christus. On top of the day of the Lord, 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 podobnie w połowie czerzy, że temu. Nogie dzięki Tobie składając, podał swoim uszom mówiąc, wierzcie i idźcie z niego wszyscy. To jest bowiem telekwi mowy, nowego etycznego przymierza, który za Was i za wielu będzie wydany na odpuszczeniu grzechów. To czyń się na moją namiotę.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall.
Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a few announcements. First of all, today's bulletin has the entire schedule for Holy Week and Easter, so we invite everyone to make themselves available to it. Also, we have at the entrances of the church envelopes for both Easter flowers as well as the sanctuary lamp intentions. Easter flower envelopes will help defray the rising cost of Easter flowers, and so we appreciate the assistance we can get. And the sanctuary lamp intentions are those lit by the tabernacle. Immediately following Mass today, everyone is invited to the social hall for the annual Palm Sunday alumni pancake breakfast. So we hope to see everyone there. Lastly, now we will have, right after Mass, that exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. We'll have Waszczyzna, Baron Waszczyzna, be the Polish reflection in lieu of the homily at the homily time. And during Waszczyzna, we'll be hearing confessions. And if those are not completed by the end, then after Waszczyzna, we'll continue to all are finished. Thank everyone for being with us today, and we hope that you have a truly holy week. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. Look, we pray, O Lord, upon this short family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked and submit to the agony of the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Change church. Te ostatni cięższy będziemy rozdobrać. Co Pan Jezus nie cierpia od chwili ukorowania, aż do ciężkiego skonania na czym. Te bluźnierstwa wziął żywości nie zbawi. Jakże mu wiele zonu ofiarujemy za grzeszników zatwarzał, aby zbawić się, powodził ich serca, wąkane do pokuty, prawdziwe życie poprawy oraz za duszy czystszym, cierpiącym, aby im litości Jezus krwią swoją święto ogień zagasł. Prośmy na to, by nam wyjednał na godzinę śmierci z trudem, że grzechy i szczęśliwy własny Boże wytrwa. Mój drodzy Chrystusie Panu, co zapamiętamy z dzisiejszej liturgii? Poświęcenie Pan na pamiątkę wjazdu Jezusa do Jerozolimy i Jego miasta. Dwa bardzo kontrastujące ze sobą wydarzenia. Uroczysty wjazd Jezusa do Jerozolimy. Ludzie zgotowali mu niemal królewskie powitanie, ale i w płaszczu rzucane pod nogi Mesjasza, wjazd działającego na oślęciu robią wrażenie. Ponadto okrzyki hozana i błogosławiony ten, który przychodzi w imię Pańskie oraz nawiązane do króla Dawida sugerują, że Jezus jest kimś więcej niż tylko nauczyciel i kimś więcej niż tylko człowiek. Drugie natomiast wydarzenie jest inne w swej wymowie. Kilka dni później Jezus jest traktowany zupełnie inaczej. Ma przeciwko sobie faryzeuszy i saduceuszy, którzy oburzają ludzi. W ogóle atmosfera wokół Jezusa jest miała dnia nadziei. Liturgia słowo ostatnich dni bardzo to określała. Opór i zawracałość serc. Tych, którzy najlepiej wiedzieli, jakie będzie znaki czasów mesjańskich, ich blokada na to, co mówił i robił Jezus, doprowadziły do takiego stanu rzeczy. Warto w tym miejscu zwrócić uwagę na nasze, moje i Twoje podejście do Jezusa, naszą niestałość uczuć wobec Niego. Czasem przypływie emocji, kiedy czujemy się dobrze, kiedy całkiem nieźle układa się w naszym życiu, jesteśmy jak ci, którzy witali go wjeżdżającego do Jerozolimy. W kolei, kiedy w naszym życiu układa się nie po naszym życiu, przeżywamy kłopoty, nawet cierpienie, to niejednokrotnie sadzamy go na ławie oskarżonych, bo to on jest winny naszych nieszczęść. To on jest odpowiedzialny za nasze cierpienie. Warto sobie uświadomić, że jesteśmy zdolni do uwielbienia Boga, ale także do tego, żeby go oskarżyć, doprowadzić do jego ukrzyżowania. Co zresztą także sugerują Pismo Święte czy prawdy naszej wiary, bo to my, oto nasze grzechy doprowadziły do śmierci Jezusa. Wchodzimy w przeżywanie Wielkiego Tygodnia. Za kilka dni Triduum Paschalne, podczas którego będziemy przeżywać największe tajemnice naszej wiary. Chociaż sformułowanie tajemnicy naszej wiary brzmi bardzo sucho i wręcz skampowo, to jednak gdy się to wszystko zagłębić, przemyśleć i przemodlić, to okazuje się, iż owo stwierdzenie sprowadza się do tajemnicy miłości Boga do człowieka, do każdego z nas. Tajemnicą bowiem jest to, dlaczego Bóg nas kocha, dlaczego się tak totalnie poniżał, aż do ogłoszenia, że wszystkiego, skoro my jesteśmy grzesznikami. Jednakże te zagadki, te tajemnicy nie musimy rozwiązywać. Naszym zadaniem jest odkrycie,
přijemšete bez zamilkowy i darmo nam na miłość. Niech kolejny wielki tydzień, który dzisiaj rozpoczyna, może nam ją odkryć i niech na nowo rozpali w nas miłość, który będzie w stanie odpowiedzieć Bogu na Jego zbawcze zaangażowanie w Jezusie Chrystusie.